I'm Jonathan Ayres with Networked for Success to talk to you today about what is a self-extracting file. Well, first off, we have to understand that in order to have a self-extracting file, we have to have a file that has been modified in the first place by compressing it, because you can't extract it unless it's been compressed. So first thing we have to do is compress our file, and then we're going to put a little command in that file that's compressed so that when you send it over to somebody else, all they have to do is click on it and it automatically uncompresses itself. Now, the program that most people use is called WinZip, and they call zip files. That's what they call their compressing. So what we're going to do is we're going to compress a file, and then we're going to make it a self-extracting compressed file so that when I send it to someone else, they don't have to have a program to unzip it or anything. They just click on it and it decompresses itself automatically for them on the other end. Also, I want to mention, why would we ever want to do something like that? Well, typically we want to do that when a file is very large and we'd like to make it smaller in order to send it across a network or over the internet. Let's look at an example right now on this computer. Here in front of us, we have a file. It's just a regular Word document file. I've already installed the WinZip program. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to this Word document, and I'm going to right-click on it, and I'm going to go down to the WinZip, and WinZip says Add to Zip File. That's what I'm going to do, because I'm going to zip this file. So I'm going to add it to a zip file. Now it comes up and it asks me, what name do I want to have? And I put the name on there with the .zip at the end. I click on Add, and there it is. It tells me that I've saved an awful lot of space, gone from 28 down to 5 kilobytes. And I have a file that's ready to go. However, if I sent that file over to you and you didn't have a program to extract it, you couldn't look at it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fix that problem by making this file a self-extracting file. And the way that you do that in this program is you highlight the file, you click on Actions, and you go down to Make.exe file, or do a Shift-K for keyboard. Clicking on Make.exe file allows you to turn this in to a self-extracting file. All you do is click on OK, let it go through, and answer the questions, and you'll be done. And that's really all there is to it. It's quite simple. Then you can send it over to somebody, and it will open automatically for them.